concert about songs.
The concert was amazing, was fantastic, with a wonderful crowd and with a beautiful atmosphere. I'm so glad to be here tonight. I was so glad to be here tonight. Many thanks. Thank you. Grazie, Leopolis.
Young, but you are playing with a star of jazz music. How is it? Who was the best for you in the feeling?
The best. It's a great feeling. It's really fun. I just feel really lucky. I feel like all the time I get to play with really amazing musicians. And in New York, where I'm living right now, there's just so much going on. And in Canada, where I'm from, there's really a lot of amazing players too. So it's very fortunate.
About the band you're playing with?
Yeah, so Martin Nevin and Jimmy McBride, the bassist and the drummer, I've played with quite a bit since I moved to New York. We just did a tour of Europe in March. So we were in Europe for about 2.5 weeks. We got to Poland, was the closest we got to Ukraine. So we were very close to here. We were in Krakow. But it's great to be back. I love it here so much. So anytime I can come to Europe and this part of the world, it's the best.
And now I want to talk about your albums.
Yeah.
Yeah. And feelings, emotions you are put in that.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's a good outlet for writing music and performing and trying to communicate something that you're feeling. So a lot of them, I think, represent different times in my life. So they're all pretty different. And I think the music that I'm working on now is a little bit different too. It kind of reflects maybe what you're going through or living through, and that can kind of come out as a kind of, you know, as a timepiece. Yeah.
Maybe a few words about the last one.
Yeah.
What inspired you? What are you listening to? And what you are writing?
Yeah. So the last album, I spent a little bit of time in New York before I kind of brought together a group to record something. So I had already played with a lot of people. Jimmy's on the record, who's here, and we had already just kind of played a lot in some other people's bands and just casually and just in a lot of different situations. So there was a group of other musicians that were like that all kind of came together and I knew would work well together. And I presented music that I'd been working on for a bit for those musicians in mind. And we all kind of came together, did some tours, spent some time in the recording studio and kind of worked on that as a project. We'll be right back.
неймовірний майстер-клас, отримала масу задоволення.
Vorrei ringraziare tantissimo per questo bellissimo masterclass.
Grazie.
Але ви знаєте, в мене от весь майстер-клас було величезне бажання поставити запитання про телебачення і про книги.
Tutto il tempo volevo fare una domanda che riguarda la televisione.
Але я розуміла, якщо це зроблю, то музиканти мене з'їдять просто.
Però ho capito che se lo faccio, музичисти мені ammazzano.
Ah, okay.
Тому, власне, хочу зараз трішки про це поговорити. Як ви встигаєте це поєднувати? Кілька слів про ваші програми.
Abbinare tutto e seguire tutto.
Ah, non ci riesco.
Мені не получается это все.
Faccio molte cose tutte insieme.
Очень много вещей, которые делаю одновременно.
Per cui vado, seguo un po' l'onda di quello che ho voglia di fare.
Я как бы слежу за волной. Вот что мне больше сейчас нравится, то я и делаю.
Ad esempio, adesso non ho voglia di fare programmi televisivi.
Сейчас мне уже не хочется за не делать телевизионные программы, потому что мне больше сейчас мне больше интересно играть.
Кілька слів, будь ласка, про ваші книги. Я знаю про те, що вийшла новела, і є ще кілька з музичною тематикою.
Alcuni libri. Io conosco la novella. Altre cose?
Ah, guarda, ho scritto un romanzo, una novella, in effetti.
Da, я написав вот эту новеллу.
Due libri sulla musica.
Due книжки о музыке.
E un libro che è in realtà un'intervista a altre tre persone.
И книга, которая в реальности это интервью с тремя людьми.
Sul tema degli alieni.
Вот именно о пришельцах.
Sia gli alieni veri e propri che la metafora.
И там эти пришельцы как именно как они как пришельцы и как метафора.
E quindi le implicazioni filosofiche.
То есть такие вот философские размышления.
Che porta questo argomento.
На которые которым приходишь, когда думаешь об этой теме.
А коли досліджувала вашу біографію, мені було ще дуже цікаво, чому тільки кілька років тому, три, так, вийшов перший ваш альбом як сонграйтера?
Perché lei segue la tua biografia e pensa come mai che solo tre anni fa è uscito il tuo primo album come songwriter?
Ah, ma non è neanche un album da songwriter.
Ah?
Cioè, in realtà io canto solo tre canzoni in quell'album.
На самом деле, в этом альбоме пою только три песни.
Perché mi sono uscite tre canzoni.
Потому что у меня так вышло.
Non ne avevo di più.
У меня больше их не было.
Quindi il resto dell'album è strumentale.
Поэтому остальные пьесы в этом альбоме инструментальные.
Perché io da sempre ammiro molto quelli che riescono a condensare in tre minuti, quattro minuti di canzone una storia.
Потому что я очень для меня самое ценное это когда получается в 3-4 минуты уложить
una storia, un racconto.
Рассказать историю.
Di solito i musicisti di jazz invece improvvisano molto e quindi hanno bisogno di molto tempo.
Джазмены обычно у них им нужно много времени, чтобы вот импровизировать длинные, а мне я ценю очень короткие. Вот когда история рассказывается за очень короткое время.
И, власне, ще мене дуже часто дивують такі люди, як ви, тому що часто музиканти кажуть, мені легше зіграти, ніж щось тобі розповісти про цей твір.
Spesso succede quando lei fa interviste che i musicisti dicono, a per me è più semplice suonare che rispondere alle tue domande.
І знову ж таки повертаюсь до телебачення.
І знову ж таки повертаюся до театру. Театру.
Що у вас більше проявлялося в тому плані? Коли ви вирішили спробувати свої сили як ведучий, так і як актор?
Quando e perché hai deciso di sperimentare anche come conduttore o come attore?
Lo volevo fare da bambino.
Я это с детства хотел.
Da bambino io volevo stare su un palco.
Я с детства хотел стоять на сцене.
Quindi in realtà non credo di fare molte cose diverse fra loro.
Поэтому я не думаю, что я занимаюсь каким-то разным. Это все вместе. Я не думаю, что я занимаюсь разными вещами.
Per me è sempre la stessa.
È все время одно и то же.
È solo fatta con tecniche diverse.
Только техника разная.
Sì.
Ну, і хочу повернутися до концерту, який ми дуже сьогодні чекаємо.
Al concerto che
Neapoli
aspettiamo stasera.
Sì. Музиканти, які сьогодні з вами будуть на сцені.
Un po' anche di musicisti che suonano con te.
Sì, stasera una versione speciale del progetto.
Oggi, сьогодні буде особлена версія
этого проекта. Abbiamo un ospite che è Vincent Peirani, il fisarmonicista.
Потому что с нами будет Vincent Peirani.
Che non è nel progetto originale,
в оригинальном проекте
ma l'abbiamo voluto perché
мы его очень хотели,
per dare nuova linfa,
чтобы дать новую лимфу.
Perché in realtà partiamo da un disco che si chiама Napoli Trip.
Потому что мы, ну как бы есть проект Napoli Trip,
che è un omaggio alla città di Napoli,
это,
io amo molto.
Я обожаю Неаполь, Неаполь это как бы в честь Неаполя.
Ma
посвящено
poi,
Неаполю.
Ma questo disco è un punto di partenza per improvvisare tutta la sera.
Но это только как бы тема для импровизации сегодняшней.
E per questo insieme a me e Vincent Peirani ci sono Danielle Sepe.
Поэтому вместе со мной и Винсентом Пирани с нами будет.
Sono Danielle Sepe al sassofono.
На саксофоне.
E Bernardo Guerra alla batteria.
И Бернардо Гуэра на барабанчике, на барабанах.
Che sono due musicisti formidabili.
А это просто невероятные музыканты.
Вчера вам дякую за приділений нам час і майстер-клас.
Grazie mille per il tempo che hai
Grazie.
Dedicato a noi.
Grazie a te, thank you. Thank you very much.
To talk about concert we can hear today, yeah?
Okay.
And I know it's an improvisation, yes? It's a surprise.
It's more or less improvisation, but yeah, there is some tune, melody, but there is many parts improvised. So it's a good way to meet the musician on stage.
I know that you are playing concert in the city center, mm-hmm. and a few guys tell me that you say that you are more Italians and French. Is it true?
Yeah, in a way. Yeah, because my family roots are most of coming from Italy. Yeah, I'm from Nizza, so and Nizza was French, Italian. So most of the people from there, they are coming from Italy. So it's like a family. Yeah.
Tell about this concert this evening and collaboration with this musician.
What do you mean?
No,
I understand. Yeah, but it's going to be a première because usually there is a clarinet player who is playing in the band. So I met Stefano last year. We did a symphonic project with the Berlin Philharmonica, and we had a lot of fun to play together. And maybe this is the reason he called me like, okay, are you available to play with my band? Blah blah blah. I said okay. So I just arrived and. I checked the music and we're gonna play it for the first time tonight together.
We had talked with him this morning because he had a masterclass and he say it will be a good because it's an interesting instrument, it will be a special sound. So I want to back to that concert you are playing with your colleague. Tell what program you are prepared and maybe a few words about your feeling after the concert.
You mean?
That concert you are playing first.
Tonight. Oh no! It was amazing, really amazing. Because you know, it's also for us. It's like the beginning of the summer tour, summer festival, and it was really huge. You know, to see all these people. You know, and it was sunny at this time, so it was really nice also for us, and a really good mood because the audience is mixed also. Young people, old people, just people who are just walking in the street and just, oh, there is music, okay. There. And you know, it's something really important because we can feel the attention of the people. Okay, there are the people who are sitting, but also all around. And yeah, it was such a nice place first. And we had a great show also for us, so.
As a rule, when a musician going to the festival, they make a program for festival in a special way, yes? Not like in a concert. Is it in your situation or not?
No, for us, we did the same program, but as every concert, it's different because a lot of improvisation. So we had like kind of a set list or maybe some checkpoints. Let's say checkpoints. And then, I mean, we know what kind of story we have to tell, but we don't know how we're going to tell it, you know? And so this is the main thing we do.
And of course, I want to talk about your instrument. It's so special.
Yeah, but you know.
And I know that you play before this instrument, you play another one.
I play clarinet.
Yes.
I used to play clarinet. Oh, yeah. Okay, you did your research. I was talking with some guys because when I was younger, I did some many competition, you know. And in all the competition, there are some Ukrainian players who play the bayan. It's a bayan, that's right. So I know here the people, they know this instrument, you know. And so it's kind of a little bit pressure, but it's fun, you know. It's nice.
Стефано і про ті пісні, які приготували нам сьогодні.
Ти sei dimenticata che ha chiesto.
Perché oggi preparato per napoletano per questa sera.
Ma io sono l'unico che in questa band non sa suonare jazz. Non sono un jazzista, però sono l'unico napoletano.
Він один єдиний, який з цього бенду, який не знає, як грати джаз, але він також один єдиний з Неаполя, неаполітанець.
Quindi col sassofono io riesco a fare solo cose napoletane e sto qua per questo.
На саксофоні він тільки вміє грати неаполітанську музику і тому сьогодні є тільки для того, аби виконувати неаполітанську музику.
І, власне, тоді хочеться про неї дізнатися більше. В чому її особливості? Тому що те, що ми читаємо з газет, бачимо по телебаченню, це одне. А коли є людина, яка все життя займається такою музикою, вона її відчуває всередині. Яка ця музика? Поділіться.
Якісь спеціальні тади, музика наполітана.
Guarda, oggi la musica napoletana è un po' come la musica di tutto il mondo, quindi dentro c'è la nostra tradizione e c'è anche molto di tutto quello che è successo nel mondo della musica negli ultimi 100 anni, quindi il blues, quindi il jazz, ma anche il rock. Quindi la cosa che abbiamo noi importante è che quando facciamo canzone usiamo invece della lingua italiana il nostro dialetto, che è una cosa che è ancora viva perché noi a Napoli continuiamo a parlare, a scrivere, a fare poesia in dialetto, al contrario di quello che succede nel resto d'Italia.
Взагалі музика за 100 років неаполітанська диференціювала, так само як і вся музика, яка змінюється, але особливості в неаполітанській музиці – це її діалект.
Чи була можливість вас поблукати трішки вуличками Львова, трішки дізнати щось про українську культуру і чи смакує вам українська кухня?
З'їдати джерато, чита, але ти мандіату панкозу.
Abbiamo mangiato carne, abbiamo sentito ragazzi che suonavano il cimbalum per strada, la fisarmonica, un poco di musica ucraina tradizionale, la conosciamo. La città è molto bella, però dovrebbe fare un po' più caldo e ci dovrebbe essere un po' più sole come a Napoli.
Вони ходили містом, чули багато музики, було на вулиці багато музикантів, яких вони зустрічали, куштували щось з м'яса у Львові. Місто їм дуже сподобалося, дуже гарно, тільки побажання, бо було трошки тепліше, як в Неаполі.
Ну і, власне, ще щодо української культури, ми теж маємо гарну українську пісню. Чи ви чули наші українські пісні народні? І чи для вас вони є чимось схожі чи ні?
Abbiamo anche le nostre canzoni ucraine folk. Voi avete sentito o no queste
canzoni? Sì, abbiamo sentito, la conosciamo. Io faccio un mestiere che è bellissimo perché mi dà la possibilità di girare il mondo. E ogni popolo ha la possibilità attraverso la sua musica di raccontare i propri sentimenti. E ogni popolo ha buoni sentimenti. E diciamo che questi buoni sentimenti in Italia, come in Ucraina, come in tutto il resto del mondo, a volte sono calpestati violentemente da cose che invece non hanno a che vedere col popolo. Noi in Italia abbiamo una grandissima cultura popolare, così come in Spagna, così come in Cile, così come in Sud America. E questa è una cosa che si trova in tutte le parti del mondo, ovviamente anche in Ucraina.
Questo è difficile, eh?
Però io gli avevo detto domande facili.
Sì. Lei... Ну, так, почнемо з самого початку, бо довга була риторика, що він чув, він знайомий з українськими народними піснями. І також, на щастя, маю дуже гарну професію, і завдяки їй я їжджу по всьому світі, знайомлюся з культурою всього світу. І кожна країна має свою культуру, свій ріст і свою популярну музику, і це прекрасно.
Mettiamolo così, tutto quello che viene dal popolo è buono. Mangiare, cantare e fare cose belle.
Це від людей, це і їжа, і спів, це є дуже добре.
We had a really nice time, man. The crowd, the audience was fantastic. And this is our first concert of the European tour, so this is a great way to get started.
And thank you for a great album. Can you tell a few words about that?
I just wanted to see if I could make my version of jazz and contemporary sounds, you know, like hip-hop sounds. And soul music, R&B, funk. So I'm very happy with it.
And I want to say thank you for a special song for your father. Can you tell when even you write it?
I wrote it 4 years ago, but then and he was still alive, and I played it for him. But again, when he died 2 months ago, I decided I want to redo it, just to make
thank
a tribute.
You.
To
thank you. For that.
And you. Thank you. We love you. Bye-bye.